on, Joey. Come here, help me out. Come here. Stop crying. All right. So I taught a class at the Mars Hill Blue Ridge Music Week in flatfoot dancing, and it was well received. But, you know, of the 14 students, about 3 of them had a lot of problems with the back chug. It caused a lot of pain. And, of course, it causes me a lot of pain. So I was very motivated to figure out an alternative. And Andy Edmonstone calls this, like, she calls it an old lady step. So basically, you're trying not to leave the ground. You're trying to use as little of your effort above the, little of your muscles above the knee as possible. So it's going to be a little harder to keep ready, steady rhythm because you don't have the down-up momentum thing, which is really what keeps your clockwork when you're doing a regular Tenneesee walking step. But if you build up your shin muscles and your ankles coordination, this is what it would sound like. So you still get the 1E and the 2E and the... Come back here, Bon Jovi. But instead of... when you take your step... And you, from the, that's your first sound. The second sound with the ordinary way was to do a back chug like that. That drag is what I'm. This is an alternative to. So step, your heel comes onto the ankle, and then you let your body weight come forward and you smack down on the toe. So that's a toe drop instead of a back chug. So your two sound walking step would sound like this. This is an adaptation, it's a modification, and the acoustics aren't great because you don't have as nice and accentuated second sound, which is your upbeat, and it's really important to always keep your upbeat really nice and accentuated, crisp, if not, you know, it keeps the lift in the music. But anyway, we're talking about how to dance when you're injured. So that's how you get your two sound. And to add your third sound, which for in my method is the double toe, you in a way you keep up down up motion as much as your knees bend. So I'm doing and one, you're getting that toe bounce. Instead of chugging, I'm coming down after my double toe with a heel toe drop. So. A one, two. And one of the ways to prevent, you know, hurting your muscles is just let your body weight come forward and bring that down and So that's a three sound walking step, right? You're not walking, you're actually... This is a modified walking step, three sound modified walking step. And your four sound, you would add the heel scuff in. This is the Tenneesee walking step. This is the Tenneesee modified walking step. You're getting all 16 beats of your measure, right? You're getting a 1E and a 2E and a 1E and a 2E and a. Just trying to chill out and do something not too athletic and still get knock out all the beats, right? So I haven't really mastered this, so I haven't thought of variations yet. One immediate variation would be to pivot on your heel. Because you're on your heel now, instead of doing a back chug, your weight, you lean back, your weight goes on your heel, and you lean forward, your weight comes down. So, because when your weight's on your heel, you can swivel your heels. So you can get variations like that. But anyway, the point of this is not yet, anyway, it's not to do a lot of fancy, it's not competition dancing, it's just how to dance and make some rhythm without hurting your, you know, the whole upper thigh and hamstring attachment and piriformis muscle and glutes that have to work when you're doing that. The real chug, right? That's hurt some people over the age of 40. So, this is the modified walking step or the granny step. And it definitely uses your calf. Calf, obviously, but also your shin, because like the Thomas Maupin step, you're basically using everything below the ankle. Right, that's your three sound Maupin, but, so that would go well. It's another step to do that's low impact on your thigh. So, I'm going to do it for about a minute. You could try doing it along. It's easier in taps, obviously, because you're injured dancer modifications.